Hello children, welcome back. Hope you are all doing good. This is Mathura from Ponvidyashram Kolapakkam. We are in Unit 1, Diversity in the Living World, in which we are in the Chapter 2, Biological Classification. We have seen Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protista, and we are in Kingdom Fungi, in which we have seen the phycomycetes, ascomycetes, basidiomycetes, and deuteromycetes. Now we are moving on to the symbiotic fungi, which are lichens and mycorrhiza. First we are going to see about the lichens. Lichens is the symbiotic relationship of fungi and cyanobacteria. So fungi is a heterotroph that lacks chlorophyll. So they associate with the autotroph, that is cyanobacteria, which has the chlorophyll pigment. It produces its own food. So fungi relies on the cyanobacteria for their food, whereas the cyanobacteria relies on fungi for the support and survival system. So it is a mutual relationship between the fungi and an algae, that is cyanobacteria, and also the algae also act as a autotroph symbiont with the fungus. So coming to lichen, an association of a fungus and a photosynthetic symbiont. This photosynthetic symbiont can be a cyanobacteria or an algae, resulting in a stable vegetative body having a specific structure. Unique entity formed by a fungus and a photoautotroph alga or cyanobacterium that has characteristics that neither has alone. So this lichen symbiotic relationship has a unique characteristics. So this characteristic is not seen when they are seen as a lone species. So when the fungi is alone and when the algae or cyanobacteria is alone, they do not possess the characteristics of the lichens. When they are grouped together, when they are living mutually as lichens, they have a special characteristics. They are widely distributed, grow on soil, rocks, trees, marine or intertidal. So they live on soil, rocks, trees, marine habitat and in intertidal waves. Variety of habitats, cold to hot, arid to moist. So they can withstand in an extreme conditions also. So they can live in most hot places and to the most cold places, and also they can live in a dry area to the moist area. Withstand environmental extremes. So they can withstand environmental extremes, maybe a dominant vegetation, example tundra. So they become a dominant vegetation in case of tundra, or primary colonizers in succession. So ecological succession is that in a habitat, when an organism is extinct, a new organism will take place that habitat. That is called as ecological succession. So the primary succession is that the first organism to colonize that area is called as primary successor. So the lichens plays a primary successor. Whenever the land is bare or it is deprived of any organisms, this lichens will colonize that area and forms the primary succession. Involved in weathering of rock and formation of soil. So these lichens secrete some chemicals which wither away the rock, that demineralize the rock. May exist where other organisms can't survive of desert rocks, alpine, arctic, etc. They survive in an area in which other organisms cannot withstand. So they can live in desert rocks where it is very dry and hot, and also in alpine and arctic area in which the climate is cold. Coming to the types of lichens, they are of different types. They are crustose, scamelose, folios and fruticose. And crustose, these lichens are crust like closely attached to the substratum. Example is graphis and lichenora. And coming to squamelose, it is also called as leprose. These are like minute scales attached superficially to the substratum, example depraria. And coming to folios, these are like twisted and crinkled leaf. Means leaf. So these are like twisted and crinkled leaf, example Parmelia and Physica and Fruticose. These are branched, erect with bushy appearance. Example, Evernia, Ramalina and Usnea. These are all about the types of lichens. Coming to the internal structure of lichens, they contain various zones or regions of fungal tissue. In most, the autotrophic symbiont is restricted to a definite layer. So, the autotrophic symbiont, whether it is cyanobacteria or the algae, they acquire a definite layer. In some, it is dispersed throughout the structure. Crustostylae generally have simpler structure than folios or fruticostylae. Crustose is the simplest structure, may contain various fungal tissues and cell types. Coming to the symbiosis relationship, fungal symbiont and autotrophic symbionts. Fungal symbiont is a fungal structure and autotrophic symbiont is a either cyanobacteria or the algae. Most lichenized fungi are ascomyta, that is ascomycetes. Most form apothecia, some form perithecia and pseudothecia. 12 orders include mostly lichenized members. Some are basidiomycota, aphylloferales, few agaricales. Some are deuteromycota. So, depending on the fungus type which is associated with the algae, they can be divided into ascomycota, basidiomycota and deuteromycota. If the fungi belongs to the group ascomycetes, basidiomycetes and deuteromycetes, then they are called as ascomycota, basidiomycota and deuteromycota. Here, coming to autotrophic symbionts, green algae, Trubaxia, is a common genus found in 75% of lichens in temperate zone. The temperate zone is the colder region, that is the polar region, Arctic and Alpine, where we can see the symbiotic relationship of fungus, in which Trubaxia is the common algae which act as a autotrophic symbiont. Cyanobacteria Nostoc is a common genus that relives in the mutual relationship with the fungus. Nostoc is a nitrogen fixing cyanobacteria. 26 genera of algae and cyanobacteria found in lichens. 90% of lichens contain Trubaxia, Nostoc or one other genus. The most lichens consist of Trubaxia and Nostoc. Autotroph may be free living. They can also be a free living. Coming to lichen symbiosis, a symbiotic relationship between algae and hyphae of fungus. Algae provides food for hyphae through photosynthesis. So, in the mutual relationship, both the organism has to be benefited. So, algae gives food and fungi gives support and a suitable environment for the survival of that algae. So, hyphae provides a suitable environment for the algae to survive. So, Ceridia, algae embedded in clustered hyphae. This is the structure of Ceridia in which the algae is embedded in the clustered hyphae. Coming to the reproduction, it can reproduce both asexually and sexually. In asexual reproduction, the thallus fragmentation are more specialized structures. So, it reproduces asexually by fragmentation. It can be in two modes, that is Isidia, minute outgrowths from the thallus that contain both fungal and algal cells and are easily broken off by passing animals and invertebrates and dispersed. So, it is a spike-like structure. So, when an animal or an invertebrate pass through this lichens, these spikes easily broken off and get dispersed. Okay. So, coming to the second mode, it is Ceridia. It is a fine powdery granules, also containing both fungal and algal cells and can be spread by water, animals and wind. Ceridia is a powdery granules. So, this granules can be easily dispersed by water, animals and wind. This is the asexual mode of reproduction. Coming to the sexual reproduction, it is done by spores. Fungal partner long-lived fruiting bodies release spores. After germination, the spore must meet a suitable algal partner before it can develop further. The spore has to meet its algal partner to become a lichen. So, ascomycota, ascocarps, most common spores in ascus, usually 8 spores produced in perithecia and apothecia. So, ascomyta reproduces through ascocarps and basidiomycota reproduces through basidiocarps, that is the spores on basidium. So this is all about the sexual reproduction. Coming to the economical importance, a number of chemicals are only synthesized by the symbiosis. Dyes, antibiotics, essential oils, litmus. Over 600 different chemicals unique to lichens have been identified. So when they are in a symbiotic relationship alone, they will produce these chemicals. When they are living alone, they won't produce these chemicals. So it has a very valuable economic importance as food for many Arctic animals such as reindeer. Cladonia ragniferina, reindeer lichen, is eaten by many Arctic animals and sometimes by people. So people and animals living in the Arctic area have lichens as their food. Desert lichen, Lecanura manna lichen, is collected and eaten by Libya, in people living in Libya. Dyeing yarns and as acid-based indicators such as litmus, Rosella tinctoria and Rosella fusiforme, litmus lichens. They produce dyeing dye which is used in the dyeing yarns and acid-based indicators. Arsine derived from a lichen is used extensively in cytological preparations for staining chromosomes. So cytology is a study of cell biology, and this arsine is a chemical that is derived from a lichen, which is used as a stain to stain the chromosomes. Synthetic dyes have now replaced lichenin dyes for commercial and laboratory use. So it is a biodegradable material and it is eco-friendly too. So this lichen dyes are used in the place of synthetic dyes. Usnic acid derived from lichens, especially Usnea species, has antibiotic properties against a number of fungi and bacteria including human pathogens. So this usnic acid is an antibiotic that can be used against the pathogens and parasites that harms the humans. Some lichens, Evernia prunastri, oak lichen, pseudo Evernia perfuraceae, tree lichen, are the source of an oily substance used in perfume industry. This chemicals released by this lichens can be used in the perfume industry also. This lichens are most sensitive towards sulfur dioxide. So they act as a biomarkers, biological indicators of pollutants. So that is the important feature of lichens. They act as the biological indicators of pollution. They don't grow in the place where the air pollution is high. Coming to mycorrhizae. Mycorrhizae is another symbiotic relationship of fungi. Okay. The word mycorrhizae was first used by German researcher A.B. Frank in 1885, and it originates from the Greek word mycos meaning fungus and rhiza meaning roots. So mycorrhizae means fungus root. Mycorrhizae is a symbiotic mutualistic relationship between special soil fungi and fine plant roots. It is neither the fungus nor the root, but rather the structure formed from these two partners. So mycorrhizae is a not an organism. Mycorrhizae is a structure formed by the fungus and the plant root. So this is a symbiotic relationship between the fungi and a higher plant, that is a flowering plant. Coming to the types of association, mycorrhizae are commonly divided into ectomycorrhizae and endomycorrhizae. Ecto means extra, that is outside. So ectomycorrhizae are extracellular and endomycorrhizae are intracellular. So endo means inside. The two types are differentiated by the fact that the hyphae of the ectomycorrhizal fungi do not penetrate individual cells within the root. So they just stand outside. Okay, they do not penetrate the plant cell. Endomycorrhizal fungi penetrate the cell wall and invaginate the cell membrane. So the endomycorrhizal fungi penetrate the cell wall and lives inside. So they are called as endomycorrhizae. Coming to endomycorrhizae, they have vesicular arbuscular mycorrhizae. They form a special structure called vesicle, and through which they penetrate inside the plant and forms a special structure called vesicular arbuscular mycorrhizae. This is endomycorrhizae. VAM, it is a short form of vesicular arbuscular mycorrhizae, much less known about these associations than about ectomycorrhizae. Appear to be the most common type of mycorrhizal association with respect to the number of plant species that form them. Found in species in all divisions of terrestrial plants, widely distributed in annuals, perennials, temperate and tropical trees, crop and wild plants. It is seen in all the varieties of plants, estimated to occur on 3 lakh plant species. So this worm is seen in about 3 lakh plant species. It occur in large number of crop plants and it helps in the absorption of nourishment from the cortical cells. A single endomycorrhizal fungus can form association with the roots of a number of plants. Coming to the economic importance, 95% of all the world's plant species form mycorrhizal relationship with fungi, and that in the majority of cases the plant would not survive without them. So 94% of the world species of plants needs mycorrhizae, the symbiotic relationship with the fungus, to absorb the nourishment. Present in 95% of plants, 83% dicots, 79% monocots and 100% gymnosperms. Brassiaceae, Cyperaceae and Junaceae do not have mycorrhizal association. So 10 to 20% of the plants present in the world doesn't have that mycorrhizal association. The Orchidaceae are notorious as a family in which the absence of the correct mycorrhizae is fatal even to germinating seeds. In orchids, if the fungus is not present, even in the germination, it will not survive. So, the fungus has to coexist with this orchid plants. Coming to the next kingdom, that is Kingdom Plantae, which is the largest kingdom, and it has a algae, bryophytes, tracheophytes, gymnosperms and angiosperms. Algae, they are these plantae contains all the organisms which are photoautotrophs. They forms the primary producer of the ecological system as it contains the chlorophyll pigment and produces their own food. So algae, it is a lower group. It consists of the both unicellular and filamentous organisms. Bryophytes consist of mosses, and tracheophytes, which is also called as pteridophytes, they consist of ferns. And gymnosperms are the naked seeded plants, and it is called as conifers. And angiosperms are flowering plants which has a closed seed. So gymnosperms and angiosperms forms the flowering division, and bryophytes and pteridophytes forms the non-flowering plants. This kingdom Plantae we will discuss in detail in other chapters, so I am giving only the brief description. Coming to kingdom Animalia, this also we will discuss in a separate chapter, so I am giving just a brief introduction. And this consists of all the multicellular organisms that contain a nucleus, and it must consume food to obtain energy in order to survive. All the animals has to consume food. They are heterotrophs. They rely on the autotrophs and other heterotrophs for their food. Made up of most complex organisms on earth, they has a higher level of organization. And some examples of kingdom Animalia are shark, wolf and rabbit. With this, this video is over. In the next video, we will discuss about the viruses and virions. With this lesson over. Thank you.